Good morning, good morning. I told you my job is to share with you as God shares with me so that I can get through my get through. When he gives me something, he gives me something to share. This morning, I just want to tell you to get up and count it all joy. The Bible says count it all joy. I talked to you about 1 Peter saying that it was a privilege to be invited into the struggle, pretty much. It was a privilege to be persecuted. It was a privilege to suffer for Christ, to be chosen because you were established and you were equipped to be able to do this. So how can the Bible say that it's a privilege to suffer? How can the Bible say that we should count it all joy and we should be content in whatever state that we're in, and we got bills due and we got problems in our relationships, problems in our on the inside, things that we need to deal with and heal from? How can the Bible say count it all joy? Well, let me say this to you. I want you to think of it on another perspective, okay? You got bills that are due. The lights are gonna get cut off. You're gonna get evicted. You got some things on the table. I know some people that are at that point. Okay, let me tell you something. The Bible says you can't add a day to your, and I'm paraphrasing because there's a cubit, but you can't add a day to your life by worrying. If you spend your time, if you got a 5-day notice today, if you spend your 5 days worried about what's going to happen in 5 days, then you have lost the value of today. You've lost the value of what today brings. You have to live in today, and you have to trust in God. God is going to make sure. Yes, I've been homeless, so God is going to make sure that day to day things are going to be all right. Whatever you've been through, we talked about this before. Whatever you've been through, you made it out to you till you were able to make it to the next fight. You made it out until you were able to make it to the next trial and tribulation. So you know that this too shall pass. You know that things come about, but you make it out. You know that even though you don't feel like going through this, even though you don't want to suffer these things, good morning, you, even though you don't want to go through this, you get up. Believe me, I get up on some days like, man, God. You know, I don't feel like the process. I don't feel like the journey. I don't feel like being inspiring to other people. I just want it fixed. I just want to wake up and everything be glorious. That's how some days are. It's like, God, I don't feel like this today. And believe me, and today was one of those days like, man, God. You know, but this is the process. This is what makes me who I am. This is what molds and shapes me. This is what creates a situation and an environment that's conducive for God to give me the fullness of what he promised me. So if this is the road that I have to take to get here, when I take a road to come see my family, I may not want to take that long road or that long flight, but at the end of the day, I know at the end of that flight, at the end of that road, is the people I love. I know at the end of that road is my comfort. I know at the end of that road is my peace. So take the road that you need to take. If we've got some issues on the table, believe me, some of us can go back and we know why some of the issues are there. Okay, most of the issues I know that I have, there's some doors that I open. There's some gates that I allowed to open. And God is gracious and merciful that he didn't let me die in it. He didn't let me stay stuck there. I had to go through a process to get out of it, but he didn't let me stay there. So I'm telling you on today, I'm telling you from the mouth of somebody that get up most days like, come on, God, you know, get up and count it all joy. I'm still here. I'm still able to minister your word, God. I'm still able to love on my family. Whatever the things I don't have, what about all the things I do have? Whatever experience I have not have yet, I have the capability to still be able to do that because you gave me life. And I know, and listen, sometimes, and I've told some of my friends say, you want to pray? And there's been days when I'd be like, no, I don't want to pray. There's been friends that, listen, I got a scripture. And there's been days when I've been like, I don't want to hear that. Okay? Yes, I don't want to hear that. We get into that place. I can understand it. And you may not want to hear what I'm saying about count it all joy and they say the light's going to be cut off. Count it all joy and you got an eviction notice. Count it all joy and your spouse has left you or on their way out the door. Count it all joy, because let me tell you something. The way that you deal with it is going to determine the way that you come out of it. I've said this before. The way that you process this thing is going to determine how long you stay in it and how you come out of it, because the energy that you project in this thing, it determines what comes to you. So if I sit here sad about my situation, then my situation is gonna linger, because misery loves company. So if I stay in the pot with the misery, it's gonna continue to come towards me, that miserable situation. So if I keep my energy up, if I count it all joy, then I'm able to draw positive things. I'm able to draw the things that I need to come on out. I'm able to draw the rope that I need to pull out of the quicksand. But if you stay in a mode, if you stay in a mode where everything is woe and everything is and I'm sick of this and I'm tired of this. Trust me, I've had my days and I have to go, listen, I'm giving you a tip. Go and retract those things you said. I have people around me. That's why you got to be careful who around you. I've got people around me that remind me you can't speak that in the atmosphere. Pull it back. I have to go and pull it back sometime. I've got to go and rescind some of my own words. I've got to say, listen, I said, I'm tired. I can't take no more, God. And I had to go back and say, wait a minute. No, you said, let the weak say I am strong. I'm strong because you are within me. You said that you were near to the brokenhearted. So you're right here with me. You said you are a very present help. So you're right here with me. So I can take some more because you are my strength. I can take some more because you are my force. So we have to remember who we are, whose we are, what our assignment is, what we're equipped with. He said he gave us the power to tread over scorpions and serpents, and nothing shall by any means hurt us. Nothing shall by any means hurt us. So listen, I've quoted a couple of things. My natural language is scriptural. I don't have to throw scriptures in your face, but my natural language is biblical. My natural language is God. So when I have these rebuttals, when the enemy comes in my mind and tells me, this is some bull mess. When I get up and like, man, no. When I get up like that, there's something on the inside of me because of my lifestyle that says you're strong, you're not weak. There's something on the inside that says get up and keep going. There's something on the inside that says you've already overcame this. You're an overcomer. It doesn't matter what they say. They're laughing at you, Sherelle. Let them laugh. They're talking about you, Sherelle. Let them talk. They're bringing up your past. Let them do that. That's what their energy is for. My energy is for getting up and keep moving into the future. My enemy is to get up and keep enjoying the present. My energy is for getting up, being able to motivate others so we can come on, those who want to move forward. You ain't got to worry about those that want to stay stagnant. So I'm telling you on today, count it all joy. Whatever it is, count it all joy. Get up, be your own cheerleader. Get up, push it. This ain't your destiny. Remember when you went through that last thing that you couldn't take no more. And guess what? You're here today. Remember when you went through that last relationship that didn't work out so good. And guess what? You back up and can try it again. Remember the last job you lost and you got another one, or you started your own business, or you had the freedom to be able to get your mind right. Either way, you made it through. So that's what I'm telling you today. Count it all joy, because we ain't lost nothing. If you sitting here looking at me now, talking loud, talking fast, then count it all joy, because you could not have the opportunity to do that. You could not have another chance to try it again, but God didn't see fit for that today. Today you're in the land of the living and you got another opportunity to breathe in the air. You got another opportunity to try it again. You got another opportunity to stand still while God manifests some things in your life. You have another opportunity. So with that being said, whatever's getting cut off, whatever, if you're getting thrown out, whatever it is, I know that's crazy. Like, how you talking to me? Because I've been there. When you're getting thrown out, maybe God ain't allowing some people to help you. I've been to the point where God didn't allow some people to help me. There were people that had it that would not help me. And I thought, oh my God, God, why is this like this? These are supposed to be friends. These are supposed to be this. But God won't allow it sometimes, because God wants to mold and shape you. God wants you to be dependent on Him. God wants you to trust trust him. And that's what Count It All Joy is about. Count It All Joy is about trusting God. We say we trust God, but if we really do trust God, if we really believe that we have the victory, then in these times when we get up like, come on, God, then we know. For real, come on with it, God. I'm waiting on you, God. I'm not waiting on man. I'm not waiting on anything of my own capability. God, I'm waiting on you. You said acknowledge you in all thy ways. I'm acknowledging you in my day and how I perceive this day, God. Come on with it. What is it you have for me? What are my ordered steps? Which way are we going today? That's the mode he wants you in. So count it all joy. I'm getting pumped up, and believe me, I woke up this morning like, come on, God. I don't like the cold. There's some situations on hand. The enemy has been trying to get at me, been trying to drop seeds, been trying to make me remember certain things, been reminding me of the things that are on the table that are not right. So that's how I woke up this morning. But I said, hold on, I count it all joy. I count it all joy because I got victory. I'm 47 years old, and 15, 20 years ago, I had some things on the table, but I made it here 15, 20 years later. So I'm going to count it all joy together, because I'm gonna make it some more years. I'm gonna make it some more days. I'm gonna make it through some more circumstances. Some more things gonna crack for me. Some more things gonna open up for me. So you gotta speak those things. Remember, he made the world by speaking. He didn't have to do that. He was God. He could have came and just said world be. He could have came and said world exist, but he said let there be. Let there be this and let there be that. And he put things in their place. Start to put things in their place with your mouth. I speak joy. I speak victory. I speak the fact that I've overcame. I speak the overflow. Begin to speak it so that you can count it all joy. I done got a little excited myself, so I'm going to bask in my joy on today. I hope that you bask in your joy on today. I hope that I'm trying to help you walk through this, because baby, I'm walking it too. I ain't giving you no testimony after I've came out. I'm giving you a testimony while I'm in. I'm giving you a testimony while I'm walking this thing. So when I get up and say I don't want to do this, I wake up and talk to you. So we can both say we are doing this together, okay? I'm coaching me while I'm coaching you, amen? So I love you too, Minister Donzetta. I love you. Guess what? We count it all joy. Though you know how we do it at GIW. We count it all joy, baby. So good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will be glad and rejoice in it. Stop saying it just to be saying it and live in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will be glad and we will rejoice in it. Amen. Apostle Venetia, we will be glad and look good doing it and rejoice in it. I look good with a rag on my head. See what I'm saying? Count it all joy, baby. Hallelujah.